Okay, so in today's video, we are going to be making some leaders test and a button that gives you clicks. This is for absolute beginners. This is an absolute beginner tutorial. Okay, so first you gotta go to view. I had so many things open. So Explorer should be over here. So you want Explorer properties and output open, okay? So output should tell you if something is wrong and what's wrong, okay? And you can move around, and now you want to go to starter GUI in Explorer. The little plus sign when you hover over it with your cursor. I'm sorry for all mobile users out there. I'm very sorry. So, screen GUI. Name it like, bun that gives click. I like doing no spaces because then you can't really call it out if it has spaces, you can't really call it out. Okay, anyways, so now you go into server script service and you do game, so it's calling the game, okay? Game.players. This is leader stats, so game.players, so it's going to the players. Dot player added. So that's basically when a player joins, and then it's going to connect to a function, which I like calling out a function. And this function is going to have brackets, and it's going to say PLR. By the way, you can always pause in this video, and I don't mind if you copy every single little step I do, okay? Okay, so now what you want here is local leader stats. It has to be called leader stats, or this won't work. Local leader stats equals instance.new, which creates something, and that thing that we're going to create is a folder. Okay? And now over here, you do leader stats.name to give it a name. Equals leader stats. This has to be called leader stats, all spelled correctly, okay? Cannot be anything else, okay? Now you do leader stats dot parent equals PLR, which is the player, okay? So, local clicks, okay, this thing can be named anything, equals instance, whatever you want the leader stat to be, instance.new, so, like I explained before, and except this one's going to be a int value, which is a value, which is going to hold how many clicks you have, okay? Now after that you do clicks dot name equals, I think I'm actually gonna do taps. So let me put those here and here. Okay. So taps dot parent equals leader stats, okay? And now when we test that, it should work. Okay, that's a little new update, okay? So as you can see here, it's right here, okay? Oh my gosh, what is all this stuff? Just open back up again. This gets annoying. Okay, anyways, now we go here. Now we go to leader stats. Now we go to taps. And as you can see, if you change it to like 10, and actually that won't really change it for everyone. So if you want to change it for everyone, you want to go to settings, and you want to open up the developer console. And in here, you can't really see. Let me try to move this. So it's going to be game dot so game dot players dot mini purple guy, because that's my username. Dot leader stats, as you can see here. So folder right here. Dot tap. Oh, dot taps. Dot value. Okay. Equals. I don't know. Whatever that number is. 10,000, I think. Huh? What went wrong? Nope. That's not what I meant to see. Okay. Something went wrong. Okay. Let's see. Game dot play dot players dot mini purple guy dot leader stats dot taps dot val view equals, I don't know, 20. Why isn't it working? Well, Dev Console is being so mean to me today. Come on, I'm dragging you. Yeah, it's not working today, but, you know, I guess that's okay. But, let's make the button, okay? So, the text button will be right here, and you want to search UI corners, okay, and then UI aspect ratio constraint, and then UI gradient. I want to do all in one tutorial. So for UI gradient, I think I want to do like some sort of darker blue over here, and then over here maybe a lighter blue, and maybe a darker blue again. That looks good. Kind of. It looks like we need to go into properties, go to nice little size, and then do 0.1-0-0.1-0. So that's going to make it the same size on everybody's screen, as you can see. Now let's size that button up. Okay, and just put, I'm gonna do taps. So taps, okay, because I'm too lazy to put a little, to make a little cursor And I'm gonna make it Gotham Black. Yeah, Gotham Black. I'm gonna make it black for now. Okay? So, I feel like making it a bit lighter on the edges. So, kind of like, do that. Okay, I feel like just doing this. Of course, there's gonna be a bit more of a shadow over here. Then over here, we can do that. Okay. And then right here, same thing. Okay, but then right here, it's all starting to change to like a bit more of a blue. And then same for here. Okay, I need to change this one to more of a still kind of bit of cyan. Okay, so this one's going to be light blue, but then a bit darker. Okay, then over here, it starts getting a bit more blue. Kind of like that, noticeable. Same for over here. You want it to be noticeable. Okay, now this is going to be probably a bit more full. I don't know, I just think that looks cool. I just like to stripe it down the middle, okay? So anyways, the light corners, pretty simple. Just do like 0.1 SU, and then it should look like that, okay? Now, it doesn't really do anything. So we need to go here and do script.parent. So it's like your parent, your mom and dad, but the script's parent is the text button. Same for the UI corners, the UI gradient, and the UI aspect ratio constraint. And if you want to call out the parent, then you do another parent, and then you do text button, because it goes up to the parent, the top parent, above it, and then it goes back down to find its child, which is the text button in this case. But, it's easier to just do this, okay? So now you do mouse button one click, colon connect function. So mouse button one click is a left button click. And that's what you usually want in the game. A right button's like for like pulling up is for different things. The usual side of the mouse you click is a left click. Okay? So you press enter. And now you need fire event. Well, first, actually, you need to be able to I like being able to like how do you say it? Oh yeah. Not be able to click very fast, so like local db equals false. If not db then db equals true. Wait 0.05. Wait, oops, db equals false. Okay, sorry, I had to pause it, but, anyways, now, after that, now, I want the button to, like, kind of shrink, but grow back, so I want to do something like this. Tween size, udim two, dot new, okay, brackets, and now this is going to be the end one, and I want to kind of save the size of this. So I'm going to take the size of it right now. And I'm going to put it inside of those brackets. And delete those little things. Those little squiggly brackets. Okay, and now I'm going to do a shine, and then I'm going to do out, out, and I'm, and I think I should probably do like, maybe 1.5. Actually, I'm going to do something. So it's going to be weight. Probably 0.35. Okay. I'm also going to do tween position. This one. Okay. I like that position a lot, so I'm gonna keep that. So that so now you can just copy all of what you did before. And make sure to put a 0 there, and same for on the weight. Okay, so now you wanna probably size this thing down a bit. With probably position and size like that, okay. Oh. Okay, so now we're gonna put that position right there. Oh, that's a mistake. Oh, why am I doing bad today? Okay. Now there's only one way to find out if this works. By testing. So we messed up. That's so fine. Use two control X. Control C. Control V. Control V. Control V. What? Why is it growing so big? Mistake 100. Got it. Okay. That's strange. That's small size it is, so I don't know why it would. Ah, that's a mistake. It's just like growing gigantic. Whoa. Okay, let's see the position of it right now. I think the position is wrong. In fact, is so as you can see, when you click it, it grows a bit smaller. Then we slow down that process. Or if you make it onto an R script, and just do mouse down, then you can it'll just start tween servicing down again if you click it again. So it might be what I do, but I want this to be a pretty quick tutorial, so it's already starting to get a bit long. Yep. Okay. So now you go into workspace, make a script, and make it called get tabs. But I know you guys want to just go ahead and make like some confusing simulator immediately. No, you want to make a nice simulator, a nice old tapping simulator. Okay? At first. You learn somehow. Let's see. Game. Dot. Workspace. Dot. Get. Taps. Dot. Remote event. Dot. Calling fire. Fire. Server. Okay. Now that should fire the server. Oh, made a mistake. Okay. Now it should say script. Oh. Script dot remote event. Dot on server event colon connect function. And we need to add a player thing right there. Okay. And now you do game. Oh no, actually you do player dot leader stats dot taps dot value. Okay. Now you need to do equals and then just paste it there. Plus one. Okay? And that should be it for today's video. If it works. And it probably will. And I hope it will. Yep. As you can see, you cannot click too fast. Now, yeah, that should be it for today's video. I'll like it if you do this tutorial multiple times to understand the script. Now I understand it from learning from YouTube tutorials. Yup. You have to learn somehow. And you can also learn by looking at scripts and typing it out yourself and reading the script and trying to understand it, and always look at the output if something goes wrong. And it'll tell you, okay? Bye! Yes, I mean it. Bye. You leave.